So essentially, as I said, even well-known investors have had mistakes in the market, and it's not possible that we would expect to have a mistake-free experience while investing. What I've done is, to make it very simple, I've listed out 10 simple common mistakes that we can avoid. And let me quickly run you through that. The first one is, don't let your heart rule your head, which means dimag se socho, dil se nahi. Do not get emotionally attached to your investments, and don't expect market movements not to be there, and don't keep on making drastic changes just because the market has moved. The second is, don't stop investing when markets fall. This is a big issue with most of us. When markets are falling, all of us stop investing. तो market जब नीचे गिर रहा है तब नहीं करेंगे तो कब करेंगे? जब तेज होगा तब करोगे तो anyways it's not going to be profitable. So this is something that you should be avoiding because investments made during downtrends actually tend to yield much better returns. And remember, it's a cycle. Markets that fall will also rise. The third is, while you're investing, it's always a risk. But put only that much money into the market so that you can set aside for long periods of time. Don't put your money which you need after 6 months, after 1 year, and expect that it will exactly work like this. It's not an FD. There's no tenor that you can decide while investing into stocks. Understand that. The fourth is, don't panic in times of corrections. Corrections are good. Corrections give you opportunities. Corrections give you a window to buy into at lower levels. Accepting the ups and downs is very important, and that will help you take decisions without stress. Because most decisions that you take while markets correct are irrational. You panic, you go move out at 6,900, and at 7,500, you wait for another correction. It doesn't work like that. So don't panic. Don't let that stress work on you. I've seen a lot of retail investors end up having portfolios which have very easily 40, 50, 100 scripts. A lot of them write to me saying, "We have this very nice portfolio, but mere paas bahut zyada script hai. You know, please tell us what to do with it." IPO investing, buying on tips, buying every time, adding small quantities of stocks that you think are good, ends up making a huge portfolio. A stock portfolio with more than, fundamentally, with more than 20, 22 stocks is actually impossible or most difficult to track and review. You're never being able to do that with the kind of news flow that is there. The other one is, don't time the market. It's very critical that we buy low, sell high, but that's at best a theoretical objective that you can chase. It's a goal that you can chase, but it doesn't mean that every time you know the other end of the market. You know when to buy, you know what you can do when it's buying, but it's difficult to time the market. Look for the right price when you buy a stock, not the right time. People who try timing the market, wait for the perfect time, tend to remain underinvested. A lot of good portfolios I've seen, they have a lot of money lying in cash. They want to invest, but the money that's actually invested is just a fraction of the total investable money that you have. The seventh mistake is, people expect overnight windfalls. Aaj liya teen, you know, hafte mein teen guna ho gaya. Now, this is something which everybody loves to wish for, would like to, you know, and keep on writing to us and calling us up for those kind of returns, but it doesn't happen. Avoid the temptation to look for quick gains all the time. Once in a while, it's fine, but you can't get it all the time. So you need to be sure that good businesses that deliver multi-bagger returns take years to build up. So you have to be patient when you invest using fundamentals. Technical is very different. It's a trade. It's not investing. And that's why I'm not going into that side of the discussion. The eighth mistake is, people buy because somebody told them to. किसी ने बताया, ले लिया, टिप है, कहीं पढ़ लिया. You know, these are very casual ways to select stocks when you buy into invest, when you buy into stocks. You have to evaluate, you have to analyze, research, understand, and review the companies you want to invest into. You know, 1.5 years back, just to give you an example, there are a lot of people used to talk about a stock called Vibrant Digital. You know, it was a very small mid-cap kind of a player, started with V, Vibrant Digital, that eventually turned into a company called Lycos. And just last week, there was news that Lycos has gone bankrupt. Now, people who have a lot of these kind of stocks, first and foremost, didn't know that Vibrant had become Lycos. When it became Lycos, that time itself, the mortality or the possibility of that business coming to an end was so evident. But Vibrant was being invested into. So I asked a couple of people, aapne Vibrant liya hai? He said, haan, maine bahut acha stock hai. Somebody's told me ye bahut badhiya hai. What does it do? Kuch email se leke kuch kaam karte hain. You know, kya karte hain pata nahi hai. Company ka naam suna, le liya. Kahi baar to company ka naam bhi sahi nahi pata hota. So these are not ways you can put hard-earned money into stocks. You know, you need to understand, you need to evaluate and invest in a stock that's best in class. Even in a bad sector, there will be good companies. If you invest in those companies, even if the sector doesn't do well, the company will. It's not necessary that every time the best sector and the best company only will give you returns. At times, when the sectors are down and out, the market leaders still continue to deliver good returns on the stock market. So invest in best in class. The ninth mistake is don't procrastinate, which is delaying the decision. I want to do it, but budget ke baad karte hain. Ab kya ho gaya? Bahut zyada bhag gayi market. Ab kya hai? RBI rate cut ki baat karte hain. Fir sir monsoon bhi aa raha hai, dekh lete hain kaisa aa raha hai, uski baat karte hain. So there's a way to keep on postponing your decision. Very common habit, you know, human habit. There is no perfect season to invest. You know, it's not like, you know, people, a lot of people come and say, generally, market na May tak kharab rehti hai, uske baad improve hoti hai. Maine to aisa dekha nahi hai. I mean, every day there's, as Ashwini said, every day you can make a lot of money. Same way, fundamentally, you can always invest into the right things at any given point in time. There are enough opportunities available. And if you miss out on an opportunity, don't feel bad about it. Reh gaye, nahi kiya. There's still an opportunity available. It will be different. It will not be the same one that was there yesterday, but it will still be there. So don't ever lose heart. The tenth one is don't stick to underperformers. We buy a stock expecting certain triggers, certain developments in the company's business, which don't happen. It gets delayed. But we continue to, the stock keeps on coming down. It is no more the same attractive business. But we keep on holding that on. Don't do that. It will add to your list of 40, 50 stocks, jisme 50% kachra hoga. Yeah, non-performers. Get non-performers out. Get underperformers in your portfolio out. And for that, you need to give a regular review. You need to monitor them closely. Because the moment you weed that out, the underperformer, it will free up precious capital. And capital is always limited. I am sure none of us have capital which is unlimited, saying, jitna paisa lagao, chaho utna laga sakte. It's not possible. So when you free up capital, you can buy better things if underperformers are there. So just to conclude, understanding that poor outcomes, poor results can happen even to a sound investment process. Okay, everything is right about your process, about your discipline. Everything is sound. But even then, the outcome could probably be poor or weak. And this understanding itself is a huge step in becoming a better investor. If you understand this, you will not feel bad about what you have done till now. You can always make a fresh start. So just simply put, let's take that huge step. Don't make these simple mistakes. As I said, they're so simple you can avoid them. But we don't realize when we do it that we keep on making these mistakes over and over again. So that's all I have to say.